Edvotek Instructional Videos presents Exploring Biotechnology with the Green Fluorescent Protein, Module 3, Purification of GFP by Column Chromatography. In Module 3, the GFP-containing cellular lysate from Module 2 will be purified by column chromatography. First, columns will be packed with a molecular sieve matrix and equilibrated with a wash buffer. The cellular lysate will be run through the column and the GFP will be collected using a microtiter strip. Highly fluorescent fractions will be saved for analysis in Module 4. For this module, you will need a microtiter plate, screw-top microcentrifuge tubes, elution buffer, molecular sieve matrix, a ring stand and chromatography column, GFP extract from Module 2 or control GFP extract, packing and equilibrating the column. Step 1. Vertically mount the column onto a ring stand. Make sure it is straight and that the cap is firmly attached to the bottom of the column. Step 2. Add 1 mL of 1x elution buffer to the column and confirm that the bottom cap is sealed. Step 3. Mix the molecular sieve matrix thoroughly by swirling or gently stirring. Step 4. Carefully pipette 4 mL of the mixed slurry into the column by letting it stream down the inside walls of the column. Step 5. Place an empty beaker underneath the column to collect waste. Remove the cap from the bottom of the column and allow the matrix to pack into the column. The matrix should fill approximately two-thirds of the narrow part of the column. If the packed matrix is too low, additional slurry can be added to raise the volume. Step 6. Wash the packed column with 5 mL of the 1x elution buffer. Always keep a thin layer of elution buffer on top of the packed matrix to prevent drying. Step 7. Slide the cap onto the spout and make sure it does not drip. Collecting column fractions of GFP. Step 1. Slowly load the column with 0.2 mL of the GFP extract from Module 2 or control GFP extract. Remove the cap and allow the extract to completely enter the column, collecting the flow-through waste in your beaker. Step 2. Begin to elute the column with 1x elution buffer. Add the buffer slowly, initially drop by drop, to avoid diluting the protein sample. Do not allow the column to run dry. Step 3. Monitor the progress of the GFP in the gel matrix by occasionally illuminating the column with the long-wave UV light source. Allow the elution buffer to drain into the waste beaker. Step 4. When the GFP protein band nears the bottom of the column, start collecting the fractions in the microtiter plate. Collect 4 drops per well, starting with well number 1, and work your way left to right. Step 5. Continue to monitor the progress of the GFP in the column and collect fractions until the GFP has been completely eluted. The column can then be capped and set aside. Step 6. Check the fractions in the microtiter plate by using the long-wave UV light. Identify the well that contains the brightest levels of fluorescent proteins. Step 7. Transfer 30 microliters of the brightest elution into a screw-top microcentrifuge tube. Label the tube GFP native. Step 8. Transfer an additional 30 microliters of the same elution to a second screw-top microcentrifuge tube. Label this tube GFP denatured. You are now ready to proceed to Module 4. Analysis of GFP by SDS gel electrophoresis.